This is Larry McShane, reporter with the New York Daily News. Mario Cuomo, the three-term governor of New York State, has died. He was 82 years old. The iconic liberal Democrat, a three-term New York governor, passed away just hours after his son Andrew took the oath for his second term as the state's top executive. Though his oratory skills made him a national figure, particularly his riveting tale of two cities keynote address at the 1984 Democratic Convention, Cuomo's career was in some ways defined by the jobs he never landed, president and U.S. Supreme Court justice. Cuomo was dubbed Hamlet on the Hudson for his endless equivocation about mounting a presidential bid. Despite widespread support among Democrats in 1988 and 1992, President Clinton, elected after Cuomo opted not to run in 92, offered him a seat on the Supreme Court 1 year later. The Queens-born Cuomo, a St. John's Law School graduate, turned Clinton down. Cuomo ran for mayor of New York City against incumbent Abe Beame, but was vanquished by rival Ed Koch. The bitter campaign created a lifelong rift between two of the state's most prominent Democrats, with Koch blaming Cuomo for homophobic signs that appeared during the race. Cuomo earned his revenge when he bested Koch in 1982 when both ran for the governor's seat, leaving Koch in City Hall as he left for the first of three terms in Albany.
10 days ago, President Reagan admitted that although some people in this country seem to be doing well nowadays, others were unhappy, even worried about themselves, their families, and their futures.
The convention in 1984 was the stuff of political legend. Many among the hardened political veterans in the convention crowd were reduced to tears during the speech. Though his commentary boosted Cuomo's profile as a possible presidential candidate, he never ran for the White House. In 1991, he stayed in Albany rather than board a waiting plane to file the paperwork for the New Hampshire primary before a December 20th deadline.
This nation is more a tale of two cities than it is just a shining city on a hill. The family of America, recognizing that at the heart of the matter we are bound one to another, that the problems of a retired school teacher in Duluth are our problems, that the future of the child, that the future of the child in Buffalo is our future, that the struggle of a disabled man in Boston to survive and live decently is our struggle, that the hunger of a woman in Little Rock is our hunger, that the failure anywhere to provide what reasonably we might to avoid pain is our failure. And I ask you now, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, for the good of all of us, for the love of this great nation, for the family of America, for the love of God, please make this nation remember how futures are built. Thank you, and God bless you.